was 2 days, the day before our wedding. Here's the bride to, come on, we gotta document this. Say hello, bride to be.
Hello, bride to
be. Come on.
Hey.
Say hello, father of the bride.
Hey, how we doing? Yeah, five right now. We're getting down to almost go time, baby. Go time. I'm just relaxing. Get my feet all rested up for doing some really serious dancing tomorrow. And I got that long walk up the aisle with that beautiful lady over there.
What beautiful lady?
That beautiful lady. So until tomorrow, baby. Until tomorrow. Peace be with you.
And we're out. And we're recording. And we're recording. Mm-hmm. That screen will go off while it's recording eventually. Don't worry about it. And then when you're done.
This is the last video of Eric while he is single. He's getting married. We'll see you later.
Is that a vlog?
It should be a vlog. Goodbye.
Yeah, I know. Just testing it out, all right? Testing it out. Okay.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and declare consent before God and His church. Lord, we ask you to bless these rings and consecrate Jennifer and Eric in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of their love through Christ our Lord.
Thank you. peace and reconciliation. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. For the poor and the homeless, may our care and concern for those in need be a sign of God's love. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. For our country and those who defend it, may our men and women who serve in the military be kept safe from all harm. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. For the protection and safety of human life, from conception until natural death, may all people be treated with the dignity they deserve as God's children. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For law enforcement officers, may they use their power and influence to ensure the triumph of dignity over despair, understanding over punishment, and forgiveness over vengeance. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all the guests gathered here with us today, may they enjoy the warm company of family and friends and have safe travel on their journey home. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For Eric and Jennifer, may they live long, blessed lives together. May their love grow stronger each and every day. And may they build a family rooted in faith and unconditional love. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For Francis and Louise Belge, for John and Mary Mamusha, for John Mazuka, for Stanislav Tchaikovsky, for Roman Stanislav Kabani, Victor and Teresa Batsik, and Joseph and Lucianne Gillot, and all who have died, and in all the peace and fullness of eternal life with God, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, we are so grateful for the gift of this marriage, for the family and friends gathered here today. We bring to our needs and concerns and those that we hold in the solace of our hearts through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the congregation please be seated, the wedding party to return to their seats. Eric and Jennifer have chosen to use the unity candle as a sign of the vows and the commitment that we just witnessed. Separate flames becoming one.
Join in our offertory hymn number 534, Here I Am, Lord, number 534.
Hi, this is Josh Scheinblum, amateur vlogger and best man at Eric's wedding. How you doing? We're here in a beautiful church where Eric just did, along with Jennifer, a beautiful nuptials. I just so happened to have a witness here who saw the whole thing unfold. His name is Calvin Knight. Calvin, what was it like from your perspective?
Yeah, I appreciate that. It was a crazy event. Beautiful. Had me crying. Crazy event. The both of them looked good, and Eric looked beautiful. So did the bride there. So it was great. Best wedding this town's ever seen. So,
yeah, definitely one of the best. It appears right now that we are being called. No, Eric's telling me to go somewhere else. That's how he rolls. Right now he's not laughing, but he's going to laugh when he sees this video happen. Look at these two. These two are meant for each other. It's very nice. All right, we're going to continue some more updates. A lot of wedding left.
That's
why we have hairspray. There you go.
They're gonna probably
sit back there.
Good idea, actually.
Get in the van.
All right, stop right there.
I can't. I can't see.
that's
New York. Oh, I forgot to do the hashtag. Can I edit?
Hashtag
hash browns. Who wants to do the honors?
Yeah, who wants to do the honors?
I do. All
right. Sorry, that was good.
Let's rage. Everybody close your eyes.
I know. There's two bottles. There's a bottle.
See ya, Ellen.
Eliminate
you so you get on my hashtag shit.
Oh, it's
the
my ring. I have a minute.
All right. To the
Guillots. To the Guillots. Take
one
down, pass it around.
Woo!
Woo! Rain beer.
You just got married. How do you feel?
I'm going to Jamaica!
How do you feel?
I'm going to Disneyland.
What?
Buddy. Gorgeous.
Well, once you use it once on Instagram,
I'm going
to back off on it.
Oh, I will.
Lettuce. Would you like a cup?
Did I just say that?
Yeah.
Keep it for yourself. Are you allowed?
No, no, no. Eric wanted that. I don't know why. There you go.
I expect you to look at it. I didn't mean you to look at it.
Oh. Okay. I'm ready at a moment's notice.
Do we have any more?
Tastes like college.
Tastes like an hour long church.
Tastes like last night.
What was last night?
Rough night.
He doesn't remember.
Yeah.
Except you punched him in the face.
Eric, what can you tell me about nuns who only consume one communion wafer a day?
I don't know. I don't recall that the conversation
you're
on.
Oh my gosh,
you remember that? That was a big rant.
They only live on one wafer a day.
What's the deal with pineapples?
I didn't come up.
I don't know.
What's the deal with that?
What would you like to say to your future children?
Good luck.
Good luck.
That's for posterity, and we will cut it. We're in the day where punchlines don't matter.
I am excited is, this is beyond belief. Beyond belief. I'm telling you, I am the happiest man in the world. Well, Marisha, you have raised one fine young son, and I'm glad my daughter found the man of her dreams right here. You know, a lot of people don't know Jennifer's got a nickname about 2 months old. Uncle Bobby named her Pebbles. She had about 4 strands of hair that kind of went up high. There was so much I wanted to say today. And yeah, I am the biggest crybaby.
We love you, Jerry.
I know. I've got a great brother, Jake, my brother Tom. I'll tell you right now, I wish Mom and Dad were here to see this event. And unfortunately, I couldn't make it sing with Jackie's mom and dad.
They're here.
I know they're here. But there's one thing I'm going to just say to you. You're the end of the rainbow, a pot of gold. You're daddy's little girl, to have to hold. Your sugar, your spice, you're everything nice, and you'll always be daddy's little girl. I love you.
If we find the beast, we're entitled to all the riches in Scotland, which makes me wonder, what are we doing here? But I know what we're doing here. We're celebrating love between two people. We're celebrating two people that have shared their love together for quite some time. For Eric, that day was 26 years ago, the day he met me. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Josh Scheinblum. I'm Eric's cousin. I am the best man. You can call me Eric's cousin's BM. As the BM, it is my job to ingest all of the nice things you've heard about Eric today and then soil all over his reputation. Debonair, suave, fashionista. None of these words describe Eric. What is accurate, though, if you do know Mr. Guillot, is he's a gym rat. He loves fitness. But I gotta wonder, though, you do know you don't get any bigger by looking at the mirror, right? We joke because we love you. But a lot of you might not know this, but Eric means a whole lot to me. And when Eric told me that he wanted me to be his best man, I had a little pressure. It's not easy writing a 30-minute speech. So I didn't think what any smart guy is going to do. I went online. I viewed thousands of web pages. And it really wasn't until an hour or so ago my wife had to remind me, Josh, you know you're looking up best man speeches, right? You know, Eric has been there for me when times have been tough. He's been there for me when times have been really good. And, you know, Eric for me is a brother in every sense of the word. He ventured out when I was living in Iowa, not once but twice. If you don't know where that is, it's pretty close to Idaho. And Eric was, he was the sponsor of my confirmation, which makes him my godfather. I only have one sponsor, so we like to joke. You're also my godmother. For those of you not completely familiar with the catechism, let me get you up to speed. Eric is Caitlyn Jenner. He's beautiful. He's an inspiration. And last I checked at my man Pepe's pool, we were like seven, all your bits are still intact. It's only gonna get rougher from here, folks. I'm sorry. There are a lot of great qualities you have, Eric, but if I had to pick one, and it's not easy, is you have always known what your calling is in life. Indulge me in a story, if you will, but it was Christmas 2001, and it was one of the most exciting moments I've ever seen Eric. Santa Claus, a.k.a. Aberration Uncle Mike, shout out, had gotten Eric his very own weather set. You had to see this thing. It had a thermometer that could tell you what the temperature was inside the house. It could tell you what the temperature was outside the house. There was a fan that could tell you what the wind speed was outside. But my favorite part was the weather balloon, which said in big, bold text, forever single. But you know what, though? I'm an everything happens for a reason kind of a guy. And I know there are a million reasons, Eric, that you became a weatherman. But I know that one of them, if not the biggest reason, so you could end up with this beautiful lady to your right. You know, Jennifer, this took a lot being up here today, and we've had a lot of great times ever since you two have been together. And I can't say enough, you look absolutely gorgeous. I'm sure you know that we consider you a part of the family, and it's so, as the best man, I feel privileged to be able to welcome you to our family. Our family's not perfect, though. My grandfather's a Yankees fan. I told myself I wasn't going to cry. Well, I forgot my drink, but we can all raise our glasses. Kanye West for president. For the best couple here, Eric and John Perez. I love you both.
Save some.
You're not saving. one more. I'm going to have to follow that up, and it's going to be pretty tough. And not to mention that this is going to be my first sober wedding speech that I've had. Ooh, talk about pressure. All right, so I'd like to start off by having us take a moment to just recognize these two lovely people who have joined together today, and how beautiful they look, and just how happy we are for them. So. As my cousin said, Jennifer, you look like a porcelain doll. You're beautiful. I've had the pleasure of knowing Jen since eighth grade. We went through junior high school, and college together. Some people say not to live with your friends, but Jen and I lived together for 4 years, and here we are. So apparently some things work out. But I think the reason that we worked out is because we were just so well behaved in college. We were in bed by 9 every night after drinking some more milk and eating some cookies, which we probably did do. Well, maybe not every night. There was the night that Jen busted out the Carlton dance and became instantly famous. She got so many beads, but we won't continue on that night.
Later.
We hosted a plethora of entertaining events at our house, which we had a lot of fun with, and we unfortunately became very familiar with the local infirmary, which we won't talk about. We won't go any further into there. So, anyway. This gentleman girl, for those of you who don't know, is quite the character. There are so many things that I could say about her that I was overwhelmed while having to write this speech, and I couldn't think of what I wanted to say. I couldn't narrow it down, so I asked my husband, Phil, here. I said, "Hey, sweetie, how would you describe Jen?" And he paused, and then I heard from the other room, "She's nuts." I paused and nodded my head. And then he said quickly, "But she's also the life of the party, and she can burp the ABCs." Those are all true things. So, another thing about this girl is that she also, and oddly enough, this is very similar to Josh's speech, when he said it, I was like, uh-oh, this is going to sound like I'm copying it. But she has always known what she wanted to do since she's been a little girl. I think she came out of the womb wanting to be a meteorologist, and I'm pretty sure her first words were something about like a negative nocturnal convection. Something like that. I'm not really sure. I got that on Facebook. So if you can imagine at the age of 17 going into college, knowing what you want to do. Meanwhile, she has me as a roommate who changed my majors as much as I changed my socks, so like at least 3 times. So fast forward a few years ago, and I started hearing about this Eric fellow, and keep in mind, Jen knows what she wants, so when she started getting serious about you, I said, "Oh gosh, I haven't met him yet, she's falling for him, what am I going to do? What am I going to do if I need to save her from him?" I learned a couple of things. I know, well, I mean, I'm 6 weeks older than her, so obviously much wiser. So if I needed to save her from this guy, I needed to meet him, but I learned a couple things about him, like, he went to college in Colorado, which is where I was living at the time, so, woo, yay! he liked a good craft beer, which again, I'm all for, and his favorite brewery was New Belgium. I believe you're correct. It's not Odell, it's New Belgium.
Well, yes.
Oh, okay. Well, okay. So he had a couple things going for him, but again, I'm very protective of her because, well, she's my Jennifer, so. When I finally got the opportunity to meet Eric in the spring of 2014, which is way after they started dating and unacceptable that it took that long for us to meet for the first time, I had the bar raise impossibly high for you, Eric. I'm very sorry. Impossibly high. So we get down to DC, and Eric greets me with a nice friendly hug, and I thought, oh, that's not going to be good enough. You got to do better than that to win me over. So all night, there I was skeptical, I was critical, I was watching him out of the corner of my eye all night long, all weekend, actually. But the truth is, it only took one weekend for me to see how much he loved my friend. So I saw him as I was stalking him. I saw how he would look at her and be protective of her and very attentive and just so loving. And I thought, after that weekend, I thought, okay, well, he passed. So fast forward to now, and I'm so honored to be standing here by your side on your wedding day, and I can't say how happy I am.
Congratulations. And now the father of the groom, Michael Guillot, will say grace.
God, we are also thankful to have just witnessed the perfect union of Jen and Eric in marriage. And now as we celebrate this union with this meal before us, we pray together, bless us, O Lord.
And these thy gifts, which you are about to receive from thy God, through Christ our Lord.
All right, enjoy your meal. And if the introduction was any indication, we're going to have one heck of a party here tonight.
I said already, but I said bye to him. Groom vision. Gentlemen, how's your little private corner here?
Yeah, my shirt. Special times. Oh, we don't have that opportunity
so cute.
That often.
So cute. I love it. Okay. I love it. I love it.
Is it recording?
Yeah.
Never gonna give you up is planned.
This is the hashtag. I'll be back.
Somebody got ripped. Oh, there it is.
He doesn't get it from any other guy. Understand, never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna turn around and desert you. Never gonna get you cry. Never gonna say goodbye. Never gonna tell. Never gonna give you up.
spin it out of your head. I wrote right for so long. Goddamn, like the same person. I say to them, you want ice cream cone? And both of them say yes.
Yes.
How in the hell?
What we got. Did you get Emma dancing? That's a first.
I did. I got her dancing.
Turn around.
Why?
I need a document.
I saw that. Trying to be all sneaky like. Who needs a videographer? Director's right here.
There you go.
Director, producer, editor. Right here. 20 minutes left in the wedding. Let's see what my bride is doing. Oh God.
Voices on this one.